Should we enjoy our interval? Are we suitably lubricated? And by that I mean, did you get to the bar and drink a lot? Just you then! You're wasted, aren't you? Are you at work tomorrow? School? No, you're off tomorrow. You're gonna be nursing one hell of a fucking hungover, aren't you, sister? Jesus wept. So, there was an iconic lip sync battle on season 4. It was a devil versus an angel. The time was about 10:30, and it started raining men. Are you ready? Please welcome to the stage, Sharon Needles and Vivian O'Hara!
Did anybody say
the fool. You are both under arrest for cross-dressing in public. Because when you look like this, it's cross-dressing.
See that chunky
headphone? I know, I can smell you. Are we gonna pick a winner?
All right. So, okay, ladies to the front, please. Ladies to the front.
Yes. A lip sync. There is a music video. Very low quality music video. There's a music video. So, who were our top three of season four? Remind me.
Sharon
Needles. Sharon Needles, well, she was a winner, obviously. Who else was there? Chad Michaels. Who else was there? Kingfield O'Hara. I'm scared the fuck out of me. So, do you know what that means?
Yeah!
It's time for the lip sync. It's time to bring back my girls. Please welcome to the stage. Oh, by the way, a large heart, the first time she's ever done that since the show. Yeah! She didn't do that last night in Glasgow. You're the first people to see that. Yeah! That iconic line, get those looks away from my face. That's the first time she said that in that outfit since season four. You're a lucky bunch of bastards, aren't you? Yes, you are. Oh, yes. So, I would like to bring back to the stage Chad Michaels, Phoebe O'Hara, and Sharon Needles!
In the city, she's on the rock, and she loves this town. Who's that girl? A ferocious lady. Get up and dance, get up, get up and dance. Shake, shake, the top of my head. Make me feel it cold.
fucking butcher for the crowd. It's like the one, the Vivian one, isn't it? So, it is my job to crown our winner of season four. I feel like RuPaul. Oh! Sorry. Next time, maybe. I like the way that Chad and Sharon just know it's one of them. The time has come to crown our winner of season four. Manchester, go crazy, go mental. Your winner of season four, Sharon Needle! It's held together with duct tape. We broke in the pad. It's held together with duct tape.
Just as much as I'm her, but you deserve this just as much as I do. And if there's anything I can say to all of you out there who has supported the most bizarre, but most relevant season of RuPaul's Drag Race season 4, that is happy motherfucking Halloween. Thank you. The sad thing is this is more expensive than the crown that Violet Chachki stole. Worked out pretty good for her. Thanks. No, definitely. I'm going to hand over the mic over to Chad Michaels and Kiki O'Hara to say goodbye to you. At the end of the day, just remember, we had a lot of great friendships and a lot of great feuds, but if you can't love your enemies, how the hell are you going to love somebody else? Can I get a hell statement here? For 8 years of support, I hope we have 8 years more to give to you. Thank you guys so much. So,
now is the time where you can ask the queens a question. One question each. So, who's got a question for Fifi O'Hara? Yes, my darling, what's your question?
How did you stay strong and deal with kind of all the negative stuff going on around you? Like, you're so strong with it.
Well, I have to remember that I get their money when they walk in the door. So I'm like, no, honestly, everyone's gonna have a fucking opinion, and I don't fucking care because I know how cool I am, and if they don't. Like, and I do so much good shit, and I like to help, and I like to do all that, and instead of being against me, if you join me, we can do a lot more shit together. And that's cool.
Who has the question for Chad Michaels? That's not enough.
2120, when it becomes Chad Michaels' Drag Race, because RuPaul will have finally died, but he'll still be the
Which I'm standing by, and I don't think it'll take long. She's like, sort of like a cunt hair away from the grave, so it's all
good. Will trans women and AFAB queens finally be allowed to compete?
Absolutely. We can go over this again, but I don't think that we need to because everybody knows what the fucking tea is. Transgender women started drag. I'm gonna be 49 this month, and when I started drag at 21, I sat shoulder to shoulder with transgender beauties all through my career. It's never made any sense to me, especially when there have been transgender girls that have gone through the show. They may not have started their transition, but they're still a transgender woman. So, what the fuck? Why not? And can I just say that Fifi O'Hara is an amazing fucking person. I've had the opportunity to work with Fifi more than any of the other girls from season four over the past 8 years. And I love her so much. She is so fucking amazing and creative. And she does do so many fucking amazing things. If you're not on board with it, bitch, get on board, bitch.
Finally, who has a question for your winner of Drag Race Season 4, Sharon Eagles. All the way over there. Fucking hell. You're not holding the mic, you can put your mouth to the mic, you'll fucking run up with it.
There's a lot of queens that have said production and look after you during the time. Is that true? Were you looked after by the production team?
Look at Jeremy's face,
can that be translated, please?
Did the production team look after you during filming?
During the 2 months of filming, we were lucky enough to have a lot of PAs that not only looked out for us, they were also our drug dealers.
Yes.
But things have changed. But that being said, we're just a gaggle of cross-dressing beauty fanatics that work for $50 while wearing $300 at midnight in smoky bars. We were not prepared to be propelled into fame that fast, and the show definitely doesn't nurture your immediate success afterwards. It was something we had to learn immediately. So they gave us a lot of drugs. So. Not cocaine, which is a real downer for me. But thank you for the question. And that being said, stepping on the side, cancel culture has been getting very big lately. A lot of people who were, and especially Drag Race fans, you've been bullied, you're a little damaged, you're a little rough around the edges. Don't get off on trying to tear someone down, especially when you know right in your fucking heart that you really don't care. And that being said, Fifi O'Hara did take a lot of flack in my season, and sometimes I feel I didn't win because you loved me. I thought that I won because you hated her. And besides all of that, if it wasn't for Fifi O'Hara, you guys wouldn't have had the most famous fucking villain of all goddamn time. If you want all rainbows and soft stuff and you don't want a little antagonist, go watch Mr. Blobby. Oh, wait, has he done something bad too?
So, anyway, Manchester, please give it up for your top three. We have actually found out this has been the Season 4 reunion tour. We hope you enjoyed it as much as we are putting it together. We'll see you very soon. But I will say, I'm not sure if it is staying over, but if it is, let's get fucked up, shall we? I've been Mother Tucker, you've been absolutely amazing. Look after yourself, Suki Suki Lata!